Hi Dita, sorry.
Dita, Mr. Elbaz, please, one picture. Dita, please, come on.
Many times, I mean, after shows, I mean, people ask the designer what was the inspiration. Somehow, the inspiration is always the tool of the designer. What is more important is the result, and what is really interesting for me is the process. Now, when I start working on this collection, I was asking myself, is the body the new fashionable dress? I mean, in a time like today when women and men, but here I'm doing women, when women can buy their own body, they can buy their face, their eyes, their lips, their boobs, their bud, do they need fashion? And what is the role of fashion designer in time like that? So it was not a philosophical question, but it was an interesting question that I wanted to answer. I didn't have the answer, but I had the question. And I started to work around this collection only with stretch. I mean, you saw all the pleats that for me were the wrinkles, and then I did all the rest of the collection in stretch. I had about 10 different stretch fabric, and for me, I started with second skin. Once I went to second skin, I realized that fashion is not really about the body. Fashion is about dressing your heart and your head. And it's not just about looking good, but it's about feeling good. And therefore, I start to understand the whole idea of glamour and dream and fantasy that we fashion designers have to supply. And therefore, I mean, I always said that fashion is like fruit, not just because they both start with an F, but because they have to be fresh, because it's not about yesterday, and it's not about tomorrow, but it's about today. And you know, just before the show, I mean, I saw you all inside, and usually I give you all interviews before the show, but this time I was totally panicked, because I saw the shoes, and I couldn't take it. I mean, I saw the pen, and I said, I'm going back to flat shoes. I mean, whether it's evening and long, and I didn't have enough of flat shoes, so I quite love the idea of going back to reality. I mean, it doesn't mean that if you wear flat, it's ugly and just comfortable. Can comfort be comfortable? Can comfort be also glamour? What is the definition of glamour? Here, this is what I said in French.
Do you have to have the kind of body, though, to wear this second skin? I mean, look, I don't think I can put one of these second skins on.
You can. I mean, I have chiffon, I have all these. You know, I'm like one fat designer that think about the body more than anything else. And you see that I have all these kind of kaftan dresses, and I have all these like boxy dresses and all these chiffon pieces. So, you know, I mean, I'm also, when I do a collection, I don't really work on one idea, I mean, in 20 different versions, because I don't think that women today do want to wear the same clothes and see older girlfriend wearing the same piece. So I'm working around the individuality of pieces. Therefore, our collection are not linear, they're much more rounded. And I'm trying very, very hard to be kind of in the middle without being mediocre, to kind of understand the need of women, but different women. I mean, there are some women that are size 34, which is okay. There are some that are size 44, which is also okay. There are one that are American and they want like a black dress, I mean, and there are other that want maybe a print dress, and it's also okay. Now the question is, how do you take all of that and you put it together without creating a mishmash? And this is a very, very tough job.
Albert, you always